Yes. Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to your English online class. Today we are going to learn about a poem which is very interesting. The name of the poem is Butter Churn. I will be giving you 1 minute time to take your English textbook, Oxford textbook, and sit in your place again. Okay, within 1 minute, hurry up, take your English textbook, page number 88. Take page number 88 from your English textbook. Take page number 88. Once you have taken your textbook, please type in your live chat column that you are ready for the class. Okay. Yeah, I got reply from Vanshika Ahana. Right, I hope others will take the textbook immediately. Right, take your textbook, page number, English textbook, page number 88. You have a wonderful poem there. The name of the poem is Butter Churn. I know everybody loves butter. I like it along with the bread. I like it whenever we cook paneer, I add butter. And you know that when we are making pizza, we add butter. And if there is nothing, at least to taste the butter itself is very yummy, right? Most of us love the flavor of butter, and the taste of butter is very tempting, that we will feel like putting one more finger in the butter cube and just lick it and enjoy, right? I know most of the children might have done it, and you might have licked it, you might have tasted it, and if you get the chance to grab the butter, I know that you may take it to your home and finish it within, you will finish it within no time, right? Many a time you might have taken the cubes from the kitchen, and most of the time you might have enjoyed the flavor of the butter happily. And also whenever we make many dishes, common dishes which are very mouth watering, there is an ingredient which is definitely added in that, that is butter. We know that in cake we add butter, and also whenever we make pav bhaji, we add butter in that. The taste of butter is very nice. Not only children, everybody likes it, right? We like butter, we love butter, but we don't know how to make butter, right? How many of you know how to make butter? Do you know how to make butter? Have you ever tried it, or have you ever seen your mother making butter? Yes. So Pranali knows how to make butter, right? Or she has seen it. Anyone else? Okay, Ahana, no mom. No problem to write no mom. Okay. That okay. Anvai knows how to make butter. She has seen at least. Vanshika don't know. And Priyanka Pidulkar, yes. Okay. Means it is 50-50, right? Some of the children don't know how to make butter, or they haven't seen, and others they have seen. And even though you have seen making butter, I hope you might have seen your mother using the blender or using the mixie jar to make butter, right? In this modern era, nobody used the traditional method of making butter in a jar. People, they used to make butter with the help of blender. It's very easy. Hands will not ache, and within a short time we can get the butter out of curd. Nowadays, the people use different kinds of machines such as mixer, blender, etc. to make butter. But in olden times, you know, when there was no mixie, no blender was there, but in those days also people made butter. How did they make? They used to make it with the help of a churn. The machine which is used in those days are called churn, butter churn. So they used to keep the dahi, that means curd. They used to pour dahi or curd or yogurt into this, into a mudka, you know, pot. Whether it may be people used to use mostly earthen pots, that means mudka. Otherwise, they used to use aluminium pot. And they put the dahi, curd or yogurt in that and add butter. Add a lot of butter. After adding the butter, what do they do is they put a churn. It is made of wood. Churn is made of wood. And they put a churn in the center of that particular mudka or that particular utensil. And it is means they put a particular rock. Usually they used to use the rock which is made of coconut fiber, that is called coir, thin coir. They used to just round that particular churn with a piece of rock, and the two edges of the rock used to be there in the hand of that particular person who is doing the churning, and they do this particular churning like this. When they just pull and release this particular coir or particular rasi, then what happens is the churn used to rotate. It used to move like this. The churn used to have the action. It completes the half circle. That is the sound which comes out of that churning, particular churning process. So this process has to be continued for a long time. It's not that immediately once you do or two times or 50 times then the butter is formed. It's not like that. A lot of human labor, a lot of time was required for the butter to come out of this thick curd. They used to put thick curd and a lot of water in that. And after doing a lot of churning, after doing the churning for more than half an hour, then yellow color fresh butter used to float on the top of that particular solution, which is very white in color, and the curd is very thick. But after the particular butter is taken out from this particular solution, it becomes very thin. And it is sour in taste and very tasty to drink. That is called butter milk. You may be knowing it with the name chaach, right? So we all like that butter milk. We may put masalas or sometimes we may put onions or salt and drink it, right? In summer, it's a very good drink to resist the heat. So it's a very healthy drink. So many of the children, you might have seen that your mother may be using the mixer or blender to take out the butter. But age-old tradition of making butter using a churn is not known to this generation. That's why the poet wants the children to understand what is the churning process which the people used to do to make butter in olden time. Right, they at least should know what was churning and with what difficulty the olden people used to make butter. And the same process is going on in the villages even today. Even today, village people used to make the butter in the same way, because if we make with the mixer or blender, we get the butter, but the taste is totally different. Those who have tasted it may be knowing the difference between this particular taste. My dear Krishnams, I am not writing anything on the board. I have just written the title of that particular. One child writes something, then others start writing the same thing. Priyanka Pidurkar. Krishnam has written in the last class also, immediately Priyanka also wrote. I am not writing anything on the board. I have written the title of the poem. I am explaining without writing it on the board. Then why the board should be clear? Why you want to know, see? What you want to see from the board? But I am not writing anything on the board. I told you to take your textbook and take page number 88. I am standing in front of the camera and I am explaining it to you. I hope you can see me, right? Now, I will recite the first four lines of the poem. You just recite each line after me. Okay, I will recite and stop for you to recite. Wherever you are sitting, you sit there and just listen it. Okay, listen one time, then repeat that particular line after me. I wish I had a butter churn. Repeat. Like those used long ago. So in my kitchen I could have a butter making show. Once again, I will read, you repeat after me. Okay. I wish I had a butter churn. You read the first eight lines yourself. Okay. First eight lines you read. So in my kitchen I could have a butter making show. So after getting the butter churn, what does the poet want to do? The poet want to make the butter from by using the churn. She wanted to do the butter churn on her own. And what she want to do? She wanted to show that to her friends. She wanted to do a butter making show. You know, cinema show, magic show. Their audience used to sit and see. Then only we can say that it is a show. If you are sitting alone and if you are making, then we cannot say that it is a show. There should be audience. So who will be the audience? Obviously, friends and neighbors, right? Who will come for seeing this butter churning otherwise, right? So the poet wants her friends to see, watch and understand how butter churning is to be done. So that is the meaning of the first four lines. I wish I had a butter churn like those used long ago. So in my kitchen I could have a butter making show. Next four lines. I told you to read it yourself. I hope you have read it. Okay. I would show my friends the magic trick of turning thick rich cream into sweet butter for my bread. A butter lover's dream. What is that show? It is a magic show. What is the magic that the poet is going to do, you know, using the butter churn? She is going to show the magic trick of turning the thick, rich cream into yellow butter, sweet yellow butter. You know that? The color of the butter is light yellow, right? So she says that it's a magic because first time when you look at the pot, she may call the friends and say, boy, look into this pot. So when they all look into the pot, they could see only thick, white, rich cream or curd in that, right? They can't see anything else, right? She may say, touch and see. Oh, it's thick, rich. And she will say, see after half an hour what is going to happen. That is going to perform this magic trick of turning the thick rich cream into sweet butter for the bread. A butter lover's dream. A butter lover means a person who loves the butter, like to spread the sweet butter on top of the bread and keep another slice over that and want to taste and enjoy the flavor of butter with the bread. Wow. Show which she wanted to perform for her Let me check better. Let me check whether I can hear myself or not in my mobile. Okay, anyhow, our time is over for the session today. So if you cannot hear, then taking the class is of no use. So let's meet in the next class. Till then, it's a bye from me. See, I can hear very well here in my particular mobile. Ahana, can you hear me right now? Shubham Dale. Okay, children, bye.